defense in a hurry.
They don't have that straight drop back attack. The wing T, as you mentioned, misdirection, and they keep it on the ground for the most part.
Delaware scored on their first possession in the first quarter, but they've been shut out since that point. Fry complete to Cooper. First down to the 41-yard line of the Thundering Herd.
There was your straight drop back. Getting the ball out to Cooper on a hitch. The Delaware Brain Trust, here straight drop back, three-step drop. Fry delivers the ball to Cooper on rhythm. McGregor there to make the stop along with Johnson.
Cooper has been the top target of the Delaware quarterbacks today, and he's lined up to the right, and they go to Darryl Brown right up the middle from the Marshall 35-yard line. In fact, all of Fry's completions today have been to Dan Cooper.
Big fullback pounds up inside. Want to keep the defense honest, but you can't use a lot of the clock. Brown pops up in there.
Bill Bergantino, Delaware starting quarterback, left the game in the third quarter, early in the third quarter, because of the flu, and Fry's been impressive. And watch that completion.
That is unbelievable, I'm telling you.
Guns it to the tight end, Fitzpatrick, for the first down.
That is a big-time play. He showed me something here in this drive. Fry almost throws the ball with his misdirection from the ground. Garrett draped all over him. Look at this to Cooper. Now that's to Brown.
That's Brown.
Brown out of the backfield.
Darryl Brown on the reception.
I was so carried away with Dale Fry, I didn't care really who he threw the ball to.
5.5 minutes to go in the game. Delaware fighting for their playoff life. Trailing by 2 touchdowns, 21-7.
Option.
Fry keeps it down to the 20-yard line. A gain of 4. Delaware has 2 timeouts remaining. Marshall has all 3 of their timeouts.
Not any quit the Delaware crowd, I can tell you that. They've come too far to give it up now. Dale Fry, thanks to his fullback, just keeps it and ducks up behind him. Gets positive yardage.
Second down and 6. Fry tries to avoid the pressure from Byron Litton, and he can't get away. Johnson.
Roger Johnson does the rest as he tight ropes the sideline.
68 yards on the interception return.
And as a flag down, I'm sure they'll call excessive celebration in the end zone.
What a great shot.
But the Marshall folks could care less. You saw Mickey Matthews, the defensive coordinator.
Thundering Herd beginning to smell a return trip to the 1AA National Championship game. Dale Fry has done an admirable job in place.
To get there. That's probably his. He hasn't hit that hard all day.
They'll mark it off on the kickoff.
Roger Johnson's going to tell William King, hey, let up a little bit.
Bryce did an admirable job in replacing Bergantino, but he threw into coverage and Roger Johnson made him pay. A 68-yard interception return for a touchdown. And with 3:56 to go in the fourth quarter, the Marshall fans come to their feet. Their thundering herd lead Delaware 28-7.
So close and yet so far.
Because of the excessive celebration penalty, Marshall's Willie Merrick will kick off from the 20-yard line. Merrick gets the good foot in it. They fake the reverse. And nearly up to midfield for the Delaware Blue Hens goes Pat Williams.
Pat Williams had a little surge there.
This has been a big day, Sonny, for Glenn Pedro. With today's effort, he now has 2,092 career yards. That is third all-time on the Marshall list. He's got 93 yards rushing and 36 yards receiving today. 28-7, under 4 minutes to go. Fry to put it up. Incomplete. Host of Marshall tacklers in hot pursuit, led by Rodney Garrett, Jim Durning, and Casey Hill.
I'll tell you what, Dale Fry can't even set up now. Must just throw the ball.
That Marshall defensive front can pin their ears back and come on every play because Delaware is in a passing situation on every down.
Watch this rush. I mean, they don't even slow them down. From the backside, there's Jim Durning leading the charge. He and Rodney Garrett. You got to slow him down.
Prize numbers adequate in relief of Bergantino. And Darryl Brown's not ready to throw in the towel quite yet. He takes it down to the Marshall 44-yard line.
You got to run the draw just to slow the rush down a little bit.
Down to the 3 minute mark. Delaware trailing by three touchdowns. Swing pass to Brown. Nowhere to go. And Delaware will be facing fourth down. Keenan Rhodes makes the stop.
Just a little swing pass. Fry doesn't want it. Gives it to Brown. He has nowhere to go. Durning and a bunch of his friends meet at the ball. That tells the story right there.
The clock continues to roll. And barring a dramatic late fourth quarter comeback, Marshall is on course for a return visit to the 1AA championship game. Fry guns it. Incomplete. Knocked away from Dan Cooper by Charles McGregor. And Marshall holds.
Okay, you Marshall fans, you can hear it in the background. They're already saying goodbye to Delaware.
And you can't say enough about the job that Jim Donnan has done with a Marshall thundering herd. Here's the pitch to Chris Parker, and he takes it down to the Delaware 45-yard line. Marshall will host the NCAA 1AA National Championship game next week. And so the pressure has been on Jim Donnan to get this team back to the championship game. He's probably felt more pressure than any other coach in 1AA football. And he's done his part of the job. He has delivered his team back to the championship game.
He has. There's no question about that, Dave, but I don't think he'll be satisfied unless he wins the championship. If you're talking about pressure.
Peyton's numbers. A little less than what's expected, but it's enough to get the job done. We're down to 90 seconds to go in the game, and here comes Glenn Pedro. And that carry down to the 39-yard line should put him close to 100 yards on the day.
What a day he's had. And what a day that offensive line has had for Marshall.
And speaking of Glenn Pedro, he is our key Centurion Bank Shares Ashland Oil Player of the Game. Glenn Pedro on the receiving end of a 31-yard touchdown pass from Michael Payton, rushing for 100 yards on the day. A $100 donation heading to the Morrow Library on the campus of Marshall University. In the name of Glenn Pedro, our key Centurion Bank Shares Ashland Oil Player of the Game. A minute to go. Pedro takes it down to the 34-yard line. That's a gain of 7.
Tells you a whole lot looking across the way.
It surely does. We're down to 45 seconds to go. I'd just like to take the opportunity. This is our last game together, Sonny. I've really enjoyed working with you and Mark Martin this season.
It's been a great day.
We've had a lot of fun. We'll hand over the 1AA championship game to CBS next week, and we wish them the best of luck with it. Pedro fumbles the football, and Delaware's got it at the 39-yard line. Just 17 seconds remain in the fourth quarter. Marshall leads Delaware 28-7. Back to Huntington in a moment. Semifinal game and returning to the 1AA championship game. Delaware's got the football. And Dale Fry, he's done an admirable job in replacing Bill Vergantino today. A flag is down. Fry lets it fly. This one is picked off by Roger Johnson. It's his second interception of the afternoon. Johnson still on his feet. That is going to be the ball game. And the celebration is on in Huntington. The Marshall Thundering Herd ups its record to 11-3, and they're on their way back to the championship game. Here's a taste of some of the flavor down on the field. Head down to the sidelines where Mark Martin is in the middle of that maze with Marshall coach Jim Donnan.
All right, thank you very much, Dale. Well, Jim, you've been waiting a year for this opportunity to go back and play again.
Well, we're looking forward to it. Great game by our defensive football team today. Played against a tremendous offense. Our offense came alive there in the second half, and we ran the ball better than I thought we could. Of course, our overall fan support and everything is just tremendous. And let's say hello to my daughter and son-in-law and grandson in Oklahoma, because I know they're watching. I love you.
You cannot get this far without great seniors.
Oh, there's no question about it. We've got a good program here. It's building up, and we're pretty happy with what we're doing, and I hope the people are happy. Maybe we can get a few more of them out here next week.
Any preference to who you play?
Not really. I'm just glad that we're there.
All right, Jim, finally, does Todd get grounded for dumping the ice on you?
No, he's all right.
Okay. All right, Jim Donnan, the head coach of the Herd, as they head back to the 1AA National Championship game. Let's go back upstairs to Dave and Sonny.
All right, Mark, thanks. Mark Martin fighting for his life down there. Back with some final thoughts from Marshall Stadium in Huntington in a moment. It's all over the Herd over the Blue Hens.
Okay, we're going to leave it.